Adrian Yonath will receive the Nobel Prize today. And I think it's a very good opportunity to think about why she deserves it and what happened during the many, many years, the several decades that she worked at the Weizmann Institute. The first thing is definitively a personal achievement of Ada. What she has been doing and what she has been dreaming for over probably more than 30 years, and her tenacity to achieve the goal of, among other things, discovering the structure of the ribosome. Usually the Nobel Prize comes and recognizes really achievement of few scientists trying to really identify what they have done over the long scientific career. And there's no doubt that Ada deserves that recognition. And we're, of course, very, very happy that she's going to receive it today in Stockholm. But then, of course, there's another point that we have to think about. And no scientists work in vacuum. And all scientists are supported one way or another by additional people, their students, the group, and, of course, the institutions in which they are working. And here I think we need to think about what the Weizmann Institute has done over the same time frame, over these 30 years, that the work of Ada Yonath and other people have been supported here at the Institute. And here I clearly believe that the way it has been done over these years is a very clever way. It is really the philosophy of the Institute to support people because they're excellent people, without trying from the very beginning to try to understand what will be the achievement. We don't ask ourselves if somebody will start work here to receive the Nobel Prize. And even often, we don't ask ourselves if somebody will start working here if he's going to solve a problem. We support people when they start working here because they're outstanding scientists and curious about what they want to do. That was also the starting point of Ada Yonath, and that is the starting point of every scientist we hire here. And I think the combination of these two things, an extraordinary scientist like Ada Yonath, and a philosophy of supporting excellent people at the Institute over many, many years, long-term support, is very important to achieve something like a Nobel Prize. And I trust that this really convinces all of us that we've been doing the right thing for all these years and that we should continue to do these things for many, many years to come so that this Nobel Prize will not be the only one that we have at the Institute in the very near future. Thank you very much.
In a short while, my scientific journey of 30 years will reach one of its peaks. Some think that it's the largest peak, the highest peak, since it involves winning the Nobel Prize. However, I think that I had some other peaks, especially when we had breakthroughs in our scientific work. And we didn't have many, but those that we had were fantastic. This project that we worked on was never considered easy. Actually, it was considered impossible, and many people with a lot of skepticism tried to stop us. Nevertheless, we went on, and the Weizmann Institute, including my group and my department, supported me throughout, mentally, in work, in providing working space, in providing machinery, and in establishing the Center for Macromolecular Assembly. Helen Kimmelman was the person that actually established it. Some people also think that since the structure of the ribosome is being determined, and we know a lot about it, this project is finished. Of course, the structure is known, but we don't know many other things. We don't know exactly how the ribosome can do its tasks, which are above and beyond my imagination, how antibiotics can stop it or hamper it, how antibiotics are disturbing, and why antibiotics are inducing resistance. We want to understand this better. We want to minimize resistance, and we want to make better antibiotics. And this is what we hope we can do in the future. Thank you.